Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.3 Beta 2 has been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and it's been okay for me. But in this video, I'm going to talk about my experience with it, then we'll talk about your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where I've compiled all of your comments, and over 10,000 of you voted, and then after I talk about your experience, we'll read some of your comments and look at the poll itself. Now, the first thing is I continue to have connectivity issues with LTE when I go from Wi-Fi to LTE. And now this was actually fixed when I went to iOS 13.2.2 on this same device. After I did a hard reboot, it fixed the problem and I didn't have the issue after that. Then when I went back to the beta with this one, I've had issues ever since. So sometimes I have the issue, sometimes I don't. It depends on the app. It's really hit or miss and it's kind of strange. But it's definitely an issue. I also had an issue with Face ID not working once. I actually had to go back in and set it back up after the restore and then upgrading. And sometimes those things happen for security reasons, but I did see someone comment about it and I had the similar experience. Other than that, I've had no app crashes. Everything's been fast and fluid. I've had no issues with scrolling or anything like that. It's just been a decent experience overall. I really haven't had any issues other than the ones I already mentioned. Now, I also have pretty good battery life. So if I go here, we'll go to battery, wait for it to load. Now my battery health is at 100%. It's a fairly new device, but it is my everyday device. Over the last 10 days, you'll see my usage here. 3 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 16 minutes of screen off time. And that is okay battery life based off of 50% usage. Now, depending on the day, if I go back a few days since the beta, that's the best day on the beta, 4 hours and 9 minutes of screen on time, and I only used about 30% of my battery life. So normally I say 10 to 12 hours with an iPhone 11 Pro Max, and it seems to be around that. I don't check my battery too often because it's always usually over half or 50%. This has been off of the charger most of the day. It's at 43% and it's almost 2 a.m. So I do record these videos late at night a lot of the time when I have a moment to do that. Now, if we talk about your experience, someone did mention that there's the double chime again when you plug in your actual charger to fast charge. So if you're fast charging, you should hear a double chime again. It seems like they've brought that back. Most people are saying the experience is good overall on all devices. So not just an 11 Pro Max, all the way down to a 6S or an SE. Most people are having good experiences. But there are a few of you that are saying you're having problems with scrolling speed and app switch stutters. So for example, if I go into settings, go home, swipe back, it may not be fast. It might not be fluid and you're just having issues with it in general. I've seen that a few times, and there's definitely people having those issues, but for the most part, most people say that it's very stable and smooth. Also, most people say that battery is good. There are some that say it's bad, but out of all of the people mentioned in the comments, over 41 people, most people are saying that it's good battery this time around. Also, RAM management with apps reopening in the background, so maybe you're opening YouTube, and you'll see it actually was still there from earlier, and that was there from quite a while ago. So RAM management seems to be fixed for the most part. A few people say it's not, but most of you do. And then there are quite a few people still having issues with email. I actually don't have any issues with email anymore, but about 15 people are still having issues with it. So it's very small as far as the group of people having issues. So I would try maybe removing the account and re-adding it and seeing if it makes any difference. But I haven't had any issues with mail, but there definitely are a few out there. Also, app crashes. There's a few of you having some app crashes. And there's also some people saying that the device is getting fairly warm when doing normal tasks. It's completely normal for your device to get warm if you're doing some intensive tasks, maybe you're playing games, but it's not normal to get hot when you're just using it like this, maybe listening to some music or going onto a website or even going to weather or any of those things. It should be fairly cool when you're doing that. And usually a hard reset will fix that problem or just a reboot. So Try that, and that usually will keep it from getting too hot. Now take a look at some of the statistics on the left. I know a lot of people liked that last time. So here's all of the different things people mentioned, and then also all of the devices that you're using, at least that were mentioned in the comments. If there was no device mentioned, I can't count it towards this. So there were probably more than this, but it's the only ones that mention specific devices. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now I've refreshed and there's 11,000 votes, so I really appreciate that. On such a fairly minor beta at this point, that's quite a lot of votes and 167 comments. So if we go into this YouTube community poll, you'll see 20% of you said it's great. 3% said it's terrible, which is actually down a little bit. 7% said okay, but some bugs. And 56% of you are actually not even on this version. So most of you are actually on the public version, which is always a smart move. And then 13% of you are on Android. And it's funny, someone commented in here, or a couple people commented, that people using Android seems to be growing now that I've added it to the poll. I just think I do actually have a good Android following as I cover their updates as well. So I appreciate you participating in it, even though this has nothing to do with Android. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. So I'll sort these from oldest first, and there's 165 comments total. Now, as far as the comments here, this one says iPhone 11 Pro and it's great to use. That's fine. But the one below it where you're saying you feel sorry for someone with an Android phone, I would say don't feel sorry. The Galaxy S10 Plus is a nice phone and some people just prefer it. Some people prefer Windows over Mac. It's just whatever you prefer. It doesn't make the S10 Plus a bad phone by any means. So it's not my preference. I prefer iOS most of the time, but there's some pretty solid Android phones out there too. But either way, 55 of you agreed with that. But I think I know quite a few people who have switched from iOS or iPhone to Android. So either way, I think is fine. It's whatever you prefer. iPhone SE, no issues so far. Not a big difference in battery life from beta 1. LTE reception is the same as 13.3 beta 1. No issues in LTE. Performance is also the same. iOS 13.3 is really good on my iPhone 7 Plus, but I have a problem with my control center where you 3D touch it, lags a bit. Now that's kind of because they changed it a little bit. So if you 3D touch, it's not quite the same. It's more of a force press, or a long hold rather, as opposed to a force press. iPhone XR, battery life is really good, 91%. Performance are good, but can be better. I noticed that my iPhone no longer heats up during standby after this update. Great so far on my iPhone XS. And thanks for the compliment. XS Max, looks like connectivity has improved. FaceTime stays on Wi-Fi instead of switching to LTE. Great battery life, RAM management is perfect. The Mail app is a little better. Still have connection issues with Bluetooth and internet issues and stutters a lot. XS Max, white, 256 gigabyte. I use both iPhone XR and iPhone SE, and I still continue to have lag when scrolling through home screen pages. I've erased both devices as well as restoring them to the latest 13.3 beta on my MacBook, and yet this still continues to happen. This has been happening throughout every version of iOS 13. These devices have run, which has been from original 13.0 betas to 13.3 beta 2. I also happen to get lag when bringing up the XR's app switcher frequently. So again, I've mentioned a few that are having this lag. Thankfully, I haven't had it myself, but I've seen it enough that it's definitely an issue for some. My iPhone 8 still has the mail glitch. When I get a mail notification and tap on it, the mail app won't show the said mail and would just freeze for 2 to 3 seconds on the inbox menu. iPhone 11 Pro Max, Face ID seems to be lagging on this beta. Notification badges don't clear after opening apps. Mail app has some trouble loading new emails every now and again, but battery is decent. Wouldn't call this one the best beta they've issued. Battery is between okay and good. Now LTE dropping out. Had to restart my iPhone 8 Plus to regain cellular connection. Cough Qualcomm. Yeah, I can't wait for them to switch to a different modem. There's definitely some issues with these Intel modems as opposed to the previous ones with Qualcomm modems. iPhone X, 13.3 Beta 2, RAM management fully fixed. On iPhone 6S, RAM management is fixed, works like a charm. As for the battery, has improved and app launches are a tiny bit faster. Had some issues on my iPhone 7, mainly overheating when doing some simple stuff, photo gallery, email, etc. turned off optimized charging. I advised to turn this off. It overheats the phone like crazy for some reason. And then I hard reset my phone and now it's fine. I don't know that it would have to do with optimized battery charging. That actually should do the opposite. So it should charge up to 80% and just stay there and not make your phone warm. So there could be something else going on. Working fine on my iPhone 11, just one small bug again in the native mail app. I'm unable to open Microsoft Office docs by clicking the share button. I need to long press on the actual attachment and then it works. Apart from that, iOS 13.3 beta 2 is a good update. Battery life is excellent and speed fantastic. I'm using iPhone SE. iOS 13.3 beta 2 works pretty well on my iPhone. One thing I didn't know is if it's just me or everyone gets this issue, but Instagram app sometimes freezes when I open it the first time for a long time, a couple of hours. I have to launch it again, then it works normally. I haven't had that issue with Instagram, but maybe other people here have. iPhone 11 Pro, and it's been okay so far. No strange things happening, but okay, I'm a light basic user. This is the first iOS 13 build that isn't draining battery. All previous builds were draining battery even without using any apps. iPhone XR, it's all right. Messages is a little bit buggy for me. I see that several people have complained about poor battery life on the XR. My experience has been very good and I do not have any issues there. However, I noticed my VPN app was chewing up the battery and turned it off when it's not needed. It works great on my iPhone 11. Battery life is consistent with what I get on 13.2 and 13.3 beta 1, but far less buggy, particularly now that most of my third-party apps have updated in the last 24 hours. In my iPad mini 5, at times when I pull down the shortcuts, there's nothing but a blur screen. In my iPhone 8, there's network connectivity issues, no problems with internet connection, but to make calls. Please tell Apple to update the default dialer with search functionality. Some of that definitely should be added in the future, I hope. Thanks for the compliment. And it says, I'm using an iPhone XS Max on 13.2.2 and battery autonomy is terrible. I hope it will be fixed with iOS 13.3. I'll read a couple more. It says, please make sure you're charging while updating. After the update, I lost 2% of my battery health, iPhone 8. Actually, you probably had already lost that 2% of battery health. It just rechecks it after it does the update. So plugging in or not really shouldn't affect that. I've been using 13.3 beta 2 on my 11 Pro Max. So far, it's been great for me. Very minimal hiccups, great battery life. Performance is good, but could always be improved. No LTE or Wi-Fi issues either. For some reason, after I updated my XS, I had some problems with Face ID. I didn't notice them at first because it always asked for the passcode after a reboot. But when I needed a password in Safari, the Face ID was not working. I locked the phone, tried to unlock it again, and there was no scanning animation or any error or message that Face was not recognized. All it said was Face ID, then asked me to enter my passcode. What I did is I scanned my face again, did not reset the settings, and it worked. The problem still occurred a few more times after that, but then it just disappeared. That's the issue I was referring to earlier. I had something similar. I had to re-add my face, and I haven't had the problem since. Using my iPod 7th generation, some issues with touch responsiveness, otherwise great. iPhone 7 and the battery has become worse, so I moved to 13.2.2 and it's slightly better there. For some reason, iPhone 7s continue to have weird issues from time to time. I'm not sure what that is. 11 Pro Max, a lot of fixes it seems, and my lockups on apps have ceased. Seems as if 13.3 is getting close to release as far as I can tell. Talk about that in just a moment. iPhone Pro 5.8, wireless charging stops working, takes a hard reset or restart to get it up and running again, but over time shuts down again. iPhone 10, and everything has been great so far. So hopefully it continues to be great. Now, as far as the final release, this particular build ends in an A, so we may see a final release. Now, at the time of this, I would expect probably this next week or the week after to have a final release, and then we may not see anything for December. Sometimes they do that, so it's hard to say what they'll do. 13.3 should bring some more bug fixes and things like that, very, very small and minor updates, and that will be it until we see 13.4 and then iOS 14 in June. So that is something I look forward to. And that's really it for this particular beta. Let me know if you found anything else in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.